For New Zion Christian Church of Suwanee, Georgia. We're a spirit-filled, transformational church marked by the presence of Yahweh God who motivates us to impact others. Our aim is to build lives with kingdom purpose for spiritual and economic empowerment. Since July of 1995, we've dedicated our lives to service in Christ Jesus. We meet in person on Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. We encourage you to join us in the sanctuary, or you can tune in via live stream from the website or through YouTube. However you choose to join, we'd love to see you here. For more information, please visit our website at newzionchristianchurch.org. That's newzionchristianchurch.org. On behalf of our Chief Executive Pastor, Apostle Jamie T. Pleasant, our First Lady, Pastor Kimberly Pleasant, and the entire New Zion family, we welcome you to join us for our live stream.
Come to hear the word of Yahweh as we come to experience an overflow of the spirit of Yahweh in this place. We are always excited. And this morning, as always, we ask you this morning just to relax right where you are, to settle back, to get ready to hear a magnificent word. But before we do that, as always, we open up in a word of prayer. Dear Yahweh, it is through Christ in the Spirit that we come before your throne of grace this morning, just giving you praise, honor, and glory once again, Daddy Yahweh. Thanking you for this awesome day. Thank you for the Lord's Day. Thank you for giving us this opportunity to come together to touch and agree as family. Thank you for Yahweh allowing us to have this awesome day to give you praise, to give you worship, to honor you and to glorify your name. Daddy, we have stepped out this morning by taking that first act of faith this morning to come into your house. To get out of our beds this morning, Lord, you made a way that we would come into the house of the Lord today. That our ears would be attuned to hear what thus saith the Lord as you speak through your apostle this morning. As you bring a word that is going to set us on another level. That is going to take our mindsets higher than it's ever been taken before. That is going to show us things that we didn't even realize or know or even understand that was on the inside. That is about to manifest. Daddy, we thank you for all that you've done to test us. To ensure that we were built up ready to be able to step out, to be able to do the things that require great faith, that require great courage, because that is what your spirit is all about. And so this morning we thank you for the overflow of love that is in the place right now. We ask you to bless those that are tuning in online, that the overflow of love, that they will feel that same love, that they will feel that same experience of the Holy Spirit, that they will experience it, Daddy, because your spirit is not limited to just this building. But Daddy, we know that it overflows outside of the sanctuary, that is touching families and communities and nations. That Daddy, your word is going to the four corners of the world. That this gospel is about to continue to explode and expand so that other people's lives will begin to take on purpose. That they will begin to take on your calling. And so Daddy, we are excited that you've chosen us, the ones that have come into your house and those that have joined online. That Lord, we thank you that you have called us, that you moved on our hearts this morning to hear what thus saith the Lord. That you moved on our hearts this morning to be excited about your word. That you moved on our hearts this morning to step out into the presence of glory. That you moved on our hearts this morning to experience something that, Lord, that only you can provide. There's nothing on the earth and in the universe that compares to you. And so we cannot help ourselves but be excited. We can't help ourselves but give you a hallelujah glory. We can't help ourselves but do a dance for the Lord. We can't help ourselves. It's like fire set up in our bones. And so, Lord, we are excited that you have chosen us. And Daddy, this morning, we ask that you give your apostle that which is not in the notes, that which will expand beyond notes, that will go beyond anything that we could ask or imagine. But Daddy, we ask that he would not struggle in the spirit. But Daddy, he will deliver the word just as you've given it unto him. That Lord, it will fall fresh upon us. New blessings, Daddy. New mercies, Lord. All of the great things that you have provided to fall fresh in this sanctuary right now. And so Lord, bless your apostle. Bless Pastor Kimberly, Christian, and Zion, Nakari, and Mama Ruby. And continue to bless us as a New Zion Christian Church family. And bless those that are tuning in right now to hear what the Lord is about to say in their life today.
because it's that word that we need that is going to bring transformation. It's that word that we need that's going to bring elevation. It's that word that we need that is going to take us to places that we did not even know existed on the face of the earth. And so, Daddy Yahweh, as we give you the praise, the honor, and the glory in this place, and as we turn this service over into your hands, we ask that you do a mighty work in this place, that you continue, Lord Yahweh, to allow us to be baptized in the Spirit, that you allow us to continue to celebrate you and honor you and to give you praise, and that our voices will be lifted high so that, Lord, you will know that we have devoted and dedicated every fiber of our being to your service in every area of life. And there is not one thing that we will not do for you, Lord. And so, Lord, this morning we give you praise, we give you honor, and we give you glory. We ask these things not only in accordance with your will, through the power of your Holy Spirit. It is in the mighty name and character of our Lord and Savior Jesus, who is the Christ, that we pray. Let the house say amen, amen, and amen. Give him praise in this place. He's a worthy God. He's a mighty God. He's an all-time God. He's an always there God. We love the Lord. Let's give him praise in this place this morning. Let's let him know that we love the Lord this morning. Let's let him know that we understand that he's God Almighty, and there's none greater than who he is. He is the one true Yahweh. Hallelujah. Give him praise in this place.
Kitchen didn't even burn. Amen. 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 That's why I asked you to lift up holy hands today to say thank you, Lord, for your grace. Thank you for your protection. Thank you for taking care of our brother. If nobody else, we know he is taking care of us. Thank God for Sister Lakeisa, who's online as well and upstairs. Minister Belinda, God bless you for being on. Minister Beverly, Sister Beverly. Also, Sister Charlene, God bless you. And Minister Christie, we know they're online. So we just want to give God thanks and praise as we welcome him into the sanctuary today. Amen. 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 We want you to get good and saturated with the Spirit today. That when it's time to give honor and praise again, that we will go before the throne the way that we should. And give God a reason. I welcome all of you out on behalf of Apostle Pastor Kimberly, Christian Zion the Car, and Mother Ruby. I don't remember the dog's name, but we're going to welcome you in his name too. Amen. Good family here. We're praising God for you being here, and we're just thankful that you're here today. Our New Zion Value Statement is posted. Let's read it together, commencing now. It says, New Zion Church, we will help you. Number one, become knowledgeable and comfortable with using the Bible and understanding its teachings. Two, experience positive and prosperous change in you and your family's life. Three, grow in your personal relationship with God. Four, discover and walk in God's unique purpose for your life. Five, help others grow in Christ. And six, become financially and economically blessed. Amen. If you would, put your hands together for the value statement All you have to do is continue to come consistently and leave here and apply what you learned. Amen. If you do that, all six of those things will be manifested in your life in full. Amen. Our meditation scripture is 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9 in the English Standard Version. Let's read it together, commencing now. But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses, so that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Amen. You want to feel the power of Christ? Boast in your weakness. You want to feel the power of Christ manifest in your life? Tell somebody, you know what? I'm not really good at that. Tell somebody, you know what? I feel pretty terrible where I messed up. Tell somebody, you know what? I shouldn't have said that. I shouldn't have thrown the finger to that person that cut me off in traffic. I messed up. You know what, though? But the power of Christ is resting on me because I admit that I'm weak. Amen. So admit your weakness if you want to experience the power of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. As the praise team comes, have a great service. Shalom and Salah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. 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 Bless your name. Can somebody give him some praise this morning? Hallelujah. Come on, let's bless him real, real good. Hallelujah. We serve a wonderful, awesome God. We're going to bless him this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, Zion, put your hands together like this. Yeah. Hey, he's wonderful. This morning,
woke me up this morning,
started me
on my way,
food on my table, brought joy
to my day.
I'm good,
your love has never changed.
And wonderful, say wonderful
is your name.
Say all of my wonderful.
Wonderful is your name.
Come on, Zion, say, all of my life,
I've never known you to fail.
You remain the same.
Wonderful is your name.
Come on, can somebody testify? He woke me up, say,
Started me on my way.
Put food in my belly, hey.
Brought joy to my day. Your love that's never changed, and wonderful is your name.
Let's say it again.
He woke me up this morning.
Yes, he did say.
Started me on my way.
Put food on my table. Brought joy to my day. Is anybody glad?
And wonderful is your name.
Everybody help us say, He woke me up this morning. Come on, put it together, say,
Put food on my table. Brought joy to my day. I'm glad you're
ever-changing, wonderful and wonderful. He's so wonderful. He's so wonderful and wonderful. Wonderful is your name.
Come on, can we just put our hands together like this? Hey, hey, say.
He's a great God, he's a great God, say. He's a great God, he's a great, say he. He's a great God, come on, he's a great God. Yes, yes, he is, yes. He's a great, great God.
All right, all the tenors, I want y'all to help us sing this.
For the rest of my life,
hey,
I'll serve him.
All the tenors,
for the rest of my life.
Come on, mighty man, help us say.
For the rest, for the rest, for the rest.
For the rest of my life,
said I'll serve him. I'll serve him.
Come on, brother, say.
For the rest of my life.
All right, altos, let's bring it in.
Say. For the rest, for the rest, for the rest of my life. I'll serve him. For the rest of my life.
Do I have a witness that know he's been good? We're gonna serve you, Lord, for the rest.
For the rest of my life. I'll serve him. I'll serve him.
For the rest.
For the rest of my life.
Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For the rest.
For the rest of my life.
We'll serve you, Lord, yeah.
I'll serve him.
We'll give you our best
for
sheep.
For the rest of my life.
Say, yes, I will.
Yes, I will.
We'll serve you, Lord.
For the rest of my life,
I'll serve you.
I'll serve.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
Say, he's worthy.
He's worthy.
For the rest.
For the rest of
he
my life.
He woke me up this morning.
Started me on my way. Put food on my table. Brought joy to my day.
He woke me up this morning. Started me
on my way.
Put food on my table.
Food on my table.
Brought joy
to my day.
Is anybody glad?
Your love has never changed.
And wonderful.
Come on, everybody, just put your hands together like this. Hey, hey,
hey, for the rest of my life, I'll serve you, I'll serve you.
Say, for the rest of my life,
for the rest of my life,
I'll serve you, Lord,
I'll serve you.
For
the rest of my life,
say yes, Lord,
yes, Lord,
for
the rest of my life.
Somebody say, I'll serve you.
I'll serve
you. I'll give you the glory.
For the rest of my life.
Hey, said yes, I will.
Yes, I will.
Oh, for the rest of my life. I'll give you the glory.
I'll serve.
I'll give you the praise.
For the rest of my life.
Say this, say,
it belongs to you.
It belongs to you.
For the rest of my life.
I'll serve you. I'll serve you.
I'll serve
you. I'll serve you. I'll serve you.
For the rest of my life.
He woke me. Everybody say, he woke me up.
He woke me up this morning.
Started me
on my way.
Put food
on my table. Brought joy to my day. I'm glad you're love that's never changed.
Said, I'm glad.
I'm glad you're love that's never changed.
Is anybody glad?
I'm glad you're love that never changed.
And wonderful,
and wonderful, and wonderful.
Everybody say,
and wonderful, wonderful is your name.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Aren't you glad we serve a God whose love never changes? He's so wonderful. Come on. Just say, thank you, wonderful God. Thank you, wonderful Savior. Thank you for never changing. Thank you for ever loving. Hallelujah. Come on, praise him, Zion. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Somebody say amen. Come on, say amen.
Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise in the house. Come on, somebody. Come on, let's praise him. Let's praise him. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, praise the Lord. Let's make some noise in this place. I want you to get excited for what God's getting ready to do in the building this morning. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Spirit of the Lord is in the place. The song has been sung. The prayer has been prayed. And now the preacher's going to preach. look at your neighbor and say good morning. Good morning. Glad to have you in the house this morning. I'm going to finish up our struggle series today out of the book of Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12 and 13. Ephesians 6. And all you got to do is say Ephesians 6 and everybody knows what it is. And the scripture says, for we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. But here's what the Lord says, therefore take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand firm. Look at your neighbor. Yeah, give God a hand clap. Come on. Look at your neighbor and say, everything hasn't been rosy and peaches or cream, but I stay faithful to God. I want you to know I do struggle, but through it all, the message of this morning is for the devil, and the message is I'm still standing. Give God a hand clap of praise. I'm still standing. Come on. Give him a hand clap of praise. Come on. Come on, somebody give him a hand clap of praise. That's a word right there. I'm still standing. Come on, somebody. The devil wanted you to quit. He wanted you to stop, but but you're still standing. Somebody say amen. So let's get straight into this morning. I will be embracive and compendious. Look at those people. Boy, I tell you, y'all some intelligent folk, man. I tell you. This morning, I just want to do this compendiously. The first point I want to lift up is this, because it's important that we stand. You're going to struggle. I'm going to struggle. We are all going to struggle. In fact, if you're not experiencing a struggle, I'm telling you now, you're not blessed. How many of you know when you were born and you were coming out of the womb, you had to struggle just to get out here? And see, the proof that you are blessed is you made it out the womb. And if you made it out the womb, that was the hardest fight of your life, believe it or not. Ain't nothing else can touch that level of struggle in your life. Point number one, during your struggle, I want you to know there are three things you got to stand on. Three things I want you to take a stand on. The first one is, during your struggle, stand on the truth. Stand on the truth. Psalm 145:18 says, the Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him. What, everybody? In truth. And I want everybody to catch this. Let me touch it real quickly. And see, you know, when you talk about your struggle, you need it. I heard, I think Deke or Pastor Quest, somebody said it this morning, is you need to let the Lord know if you're weak, tell him you're weak. Look at your neighbor, say that's truth. If you're a little anxious, tell him you're anxious. Look at your neighbor, say that's truth. If you're a little afraid, tell him you're afraid. Look at your neighbor, say that's truth. See, you don't understand. There's nothing wrong with being afraid. There's nothing wrong with experiencing fear. There's nothing wrong with being anxious. Those are struggles and challenges of life, and they are going to happen. Jesus said that don't worry about it. In this world, you will have trouble. And that doesn't mean you messed up, doesn't mean you didn't do something right, didn't mean you forgot to pray or didn't read your scripture this morning or turn the gospel on when you were driving down the highway on the way to work. In this world, Jesus said, we will have trouble. But Jesus also said, but don't worry, I have overcome the world. And if you belong to me, you're an overcomer because I already came over. So the Lord is near to all who call on him, to all what? Who call on him in what? In truth. Call on him when you're not feeling good. Call on him when you're in doubt. Call on him when you're not sure. Call on him when you're hurt. Call on him when you can't go to sleep. Call on him when you're struggling in something. Call on him when they surprise you on the job and attacks come all over the place. Call on him. Can I talk to somebody? You got to call on him. Point number two. Y'all think I'm joking. I ain't gonna be up here long no more. I'm 60. I got to go. During your struggle, and Sister Rhonda cooked some liver today, I gotta go. With them onions, y'all ain't talking to me right now. During your struggle, stand on the word. Not only do you stand on the truth, you stand on what, everybody? You stand on the word. 2 Corinthians 4, 8, 2-10, look at it. And look, somebody said, we just looked at that last week. Yep. Somebody said, we just looked at that the week before. Yep. Somebody said, we just looked at it the week before the week before the week. Yep. Hopefully you'll get it. We are afflicted in every way, but you need to stand on the word. What is it? You're not crushed. You're perplexed, but what? Not driven to despair. You and I are persecuted, but what? Not forsaken. We're struck down, but what? Not destroyed. Look at this now, always carrying in the body the death of Jesus so that the life of Jesus may also be manifested in our bodies. Look at your neighbor and say, now that's a word right there. See, some folks still ain't clapping Mother Higgs, but what that scripture means is that when you're going through struggles, when you feel like you're crushed, when you feel like you're persecuted, when you feel like you're forsaken, when you feel like you're being destroyed, the Lord is letting that happen because he wants to show himself through you to other people that you're faithful and that the devil can give his best shot, but you ain't yet gave your best praise. Come on, somebody. Am I talking to somebody right now? So let's recap. Somebody say recap? Somebody say recap. Yeah, that's what I said. I said recap. That means we about to get out of here. Watch this now. This is important. So we're going to recap. When I recap this thing, we said what? We said that during your struggle, stand on the truth. During your struggle, stand on the word. And here's the last one I want to leave with you this morning. During your struggle, stand on the power of praise. Come on, somebody. You got to praise him in the midst of your struggle. Praise him in the midst of your despair. Praise him in the midst of your challenge. Praise him in the midst of feeling bad. Praise him in the midst of things not working. You got to praise the Lord. Can I get a hand clap, somebody? When trouble comes from nowhere, you got to stand up and praise him at the moment. When everybody seems to walk out on you, you got to stand up and pray. Can I get a shout, somebody? You got to stand on your praise. Second Chronicles 21 through 2, we're going to split this up and I'm out of here. For those of you who don't know what's happening, Israel is being attacked by foreign countries. Jehoshaphat is the leader. And in fact, folks so mad at Israel and the nation and the tribe of Judah that the enemies who don't like each other are coming together to come against Judah. After this, the scripture says, the Moabites and the Ammonites, and with them some of the Menunites, come on somebody, and all of the Hittites. Oh, y'all don't understand what I'm saying. Is there anybody here? Folk you used to like and folk that you helped and folk that you prayed for. You prayed on them and they prayed on you. Am I talking to somebody? After this, the Moabites and the Ammonites and with some of the Menuites and the Hadites came against the Jehoshaphat for battle. Some men came and told Jehoshaphat, watch this, a great multitude is coming against you from Edom, from beyond the sea, and behold, they are in Hazan Tamar, that is En Gedi. And some of you might wonder what is so important about the word En Gedi. En Gedi was a place in the middle of the desert that provided water and resources to sustain life and give energy. It was the place where everybody came to get their week, month, and daily supply of water and nourishment for their household and their animals. But watch this, the multitude is coming against Jehoshaphat, blocking them from the water, blocking them from the source of life, wanting to make sure that they could get them and hold them and keep them where they would not be successful. But watch 12 through 17. Our God will not execute judgment on them. Watch this, everybody, because this is key, because everybody needs to understand what's taking place. Our God, Jehoshaphat says, will you not execute judgment on them? For we are powerless against this great horde that is coming against us. We do not know what to do, but our eyes are on you. Now, some of y'all didn't catch that, but when Jehoshaphat said, our God, will you not execute judgment on them? Notice the report came that a great multitude and a great horde was coming against Israel. Watch what Jehoshaphat does. He's supposed to be the leader, but he ain't afraid, and he is not prideful enough to admit that something doesn't feel right with him. He begins to stand first on the truth of the word. He said, we are powerless against this great horde that is coming against us. And it goes a little bit deeper. The leader, the man, the leader says, we do not know what to do, but our eyes are on you. Y'all ain't talking. Am I talking to somebody? Is there anybody here that's facing some stuff right now and you're unsure and you know that demonic forces are coming against you and you need to tell God right now and stop being prideful? I don't know what to do. See, God wants you to, he wants you to not know what to do as long as you keep your eyes focused on him. Y'all ain't talking. My Bible says, I look up to the hills with my eyes from whence my help comes. I know that my help comes from the Lord. Am I talking to somebody? There's a time when you don't need to look at your trouble or look at your doubt or look at your haters or look at the odds against you. You need to look at the one God that can defeat the multitude of all the mess that you're going through. Am I preaching or what am I doing here today? Meanwhile, all Judah stood before the Lord. Look at your neighbor and say, they stood. You got to take your position. They stood before the Lord with their little ones, their wives, and your children. Because see, you got to stand even when you don't know what to do. You got to stand even when you are afraid. You got to stand when you're unsure. See, there is more victory in your standing than in your knowing. Sometimes all you got to do is just stand. Somebody say amen. That's all God wants you to do. He doesn't want you to rock from the side. He doesn't want you running. He doesn't want you skipping all over the place and hiding. He just wants you to stand. Watch this. And verse 12 through 17, watch this now. And the Spirit of the Lord came be upon Jehaziel, the son of Zechariah, son of Benaniah, son of Jaliel, son of Mattaniah, a Levite of the sons of Asaph. And in the midst of the assembly, look at what Jehaziel says. He said, listen, all Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem and King Jehoshaphat. Thus says the Lord to you, do not be afraid. Do Y'all didn't catch that. What did he say? The Lord said to him, what? Do not be afraid. See, y'all didn't catch that. But see, some folk want a word from God, but you won't give your heart to God. Jehoshaphat admitted, we are afraid. And that was the summons that went out to God. And because he stood on the truth of God, God sent the truth back to him. You say you're afraid. Well, here, I got a truthful word for you. Don't be afraid. See, you can't get the antidote if you don't give up the truth. Y'all ain't talking to me right now. There are too many people that want to be healed. Too many folk want to be delivered, but they won't admit that they're sick. Can I talk to somebody? Everybody wants the Lord to get rid of the inflation in America. Everybody wants the Lord to lower the gas prices. Everybody wants the Lord to help them out. But the Bible says, if my people would call on my name and seek my face and humble themselves, then I will hear from heaven and I will heal the land. You can't heal the land when a man ain't satisfied with being a man and a woman ain't satisfied with being a woman. Y'all ain't got to clap right now as if God is stupid and he made a mistake when he made you. My Bible says he's all-knowing and all-powerful. And you know what's there? The one place that God wants to hear the truth come from is his church. It doesn't matter if the world wants to screw up and mess up everything, but at least you ought to come to church and get the truth of the word of God. Some folk are listening at this right now on the internet and getting ready to turn me off because you didn't like what I said, and you definitely not going to like what I'm getting ready to say. But as for me and my house, we will serve the living God. My Bible says he is not man that he should lie, and he's not like man that he will change. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And when he put a man with a woman and a woman with a man, that's called marriage, and nothing else can add up to that. I'm trying to speak truth. I'm trying to stand on the truth. I'm trying to bring healing in the life. I'm trying to bring more money in your pocket. I'm trying to get the gas prices to go down. I'm trying to get the food prices to go down. Can I get some help from somebody? Will somebody stand on the truth with me? Pray for me, Brother Higgs. I need you to pray for me. It's getting a little tight. I need you to pray for me. Thus said the Lord to you, Jehoshaphat said, do not be afraid. Watch what else he said. And do not be dismayed at this great horde. See, I want y'all to understand that. Listen at what the prophet comes back and tell the king, because the king stood on truth. Every doubt that the king had, the Lord came back with a word of truth. You will never hear from God until you bring to him the truth from your heart. You need to stop being sophisticated, stop being highfalutin, stop thinking you're holier than thou. I don't know about you, but some days my days are so rough, I don't even believe that I deserve to be a Christian. But one thing I do, forgetting what's behind, forgetting what's before me, I press towards the mark of the prize, which is the cross and salvation and Christ's blood that washes away my sin. Can I talk to somebody? I'm trying to preach the gospel. But what I love, how many of you know? Now he is able to do exceedingly abundantly above anything that we could ask or imagine. Jehoshaphat just asked to let God know he was afraid, and all he asked was that he was afraid of the great multitude that was coming against him. But that's all that God needed, was the truth, because then he went above it. Look at what God said. He said, tell Jehoshaphat, for the battle is not yours, but mine. Y'all ain't clapping now, but I don't know about you, but that's all I need to hear, is that I don't have to fight. Somebody said, well, if you don't have to fight, then what must you do? Look at your neighbor and say, stand. All you got to do is stand. Once God says it, all you got to do is stand. Once God decree it, all you got to do is stand. Once God declare it, because y'all know y'all been watching television, you can't declare unless you decree, and you can't decree unless you declare. Come on, somebody. Am I talking? Am I all right? Am I all right now? Look at this. I got to go. Here's what the scripture says. Watch this. Now God gives directives. God gets specific. Watch this. God says, you stood on truth. Now I need you to stand on the word. He says, tomorrow, when you stand on the word said, don't be afraid. That's what the word said. It said, don't be afraid. Don't worry about the crowd, because the battle's not yours. He stood on the truth telling him he was afraid. He stood on the word that God said is going to be all right. Now it's time to stand on the power of praise. Yeah. 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 Once you stand on the truth, once you stand on the word, there's only one other thing you have to do, and that's stand on the power of praise. Watch this. God gets specific. He gives directives. Tomorrow, go down against them. Behold, they will come up by the ascent of Ziz. You will find them at the end of the valley. Some of y'all didn't catch that. But they were trying to do a sneak attack. But see, when you pray long enough and you listen for your word long enough, God will show you the attack before it ever happens. He will show you what they want to do. He will show you what time they're going to come. And he will show you how to meet them before they get to you. Some of y'all didn't catch that. But sometimes where you work, you ought not wait on them to come against you. You ought to not be in response or reactive mode. When you pray long enough and you humble yourself enough and you speak in truth enough and you begin to stand on the word enough, you will be able to walk up on your hater and check them before they begin to execute the plan they have on you. That's what that scripture means. God will tell you, today I want you to go down and meet Inez at the water cooler. And before Inez can say anything, all I want you to do is just take a stand, and I want you to know that the fight is going to start. But if you just take your stand, verse 17, you will not need to fight in this battle. You need to look Inez in the eye and say, I'm talking to you, you little heifer. Look at here. I got something I want to tell you right now. You're no need to fight in this battle. Inez gonna look at you and say, what are you talking about? That's when you look Inez in the eye and say, I know you're smiling in my face, but you're trying to stab me in my back. But I'm here to tell you, smiling faces, they don't tell the truth. They lie all the time. Y'all ain't talking to me right now. That's the book of Undisputed Truth, 1968, on Gordy Motown Records. Watch this, somebody. I want you to catch this. Look at all you have to do. You stand firm. That's what the scripture says. You don't need to fight in the battle. Stand firm. Hold your position and see the salvation of the Lord on your behalf. O Judah and O Jerusalem and Zion, I'm here to tell you, do not be afraid and do not be dismayed. Tomorrow, go out against them. Am I talking to somebody? When we leave here today, I want you tomorrow, go out and look your enemy in the face and don't even smile at them. Don't play their game. We call that two-faced. A two-faced person will smile in your face and talk trash behind your back. But I'm here to serve notice on the devil right now. I'm one-faced when it comes to the way I feel about you. I'm not going to smile. I'm not going to be fake. I came here to fight you. I don't like you. I don't care about you. And you're waiting for me to throw a punch. But I want you to know that I'm so powerful now, I don't have to throw a punch to knock you out of my life. God already told me all I got to do is just stand. Y'all need to go to work tomorrow and just stand. When they talking about you and you walk up close to them and they don't say nothing. Just look them in the eye and just stand. Y'all ain't talking to me right now. Watch this thing. Do not be afraid. Do not be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them. Look at your neighbor and say, sometimes you got to meet your trouble. You got to go out and just greet your problem. You got to go up to your hater and say, hey, I know you don't like me. Y'all ain't got to clap, but your apostle, people think he's crazy where he works at, because I will look folks straight in their eye when they speak to me. And I say, why are you speaking to me? You just got finished talking about me. You don't like me. Well, now, Jamie, it ain't like that. I say, yes, it is. You started it, but God's gonna finish it, because you're touching God's anointed man of God. I might just look like a professor on Monday through Sunday. You need to tell them I might look like just a Christian on Sunday, but I've still got the power of Christianity Monday through Saturday. Y'all ain't talking. Touch not your anointed and do his prophets no harm. Y'all ain't talking to me. And the Lord's going to be with you. Somebody say amen. I got to go. And they rose early in the morning. See, that's what he told them to do. Didn't he tell them to do that? They rose early in the morning and went out into the wilderness of Tekoa. And when they had gone out, Jehoshaphat stood. Look at your neighbor and say, there's that word, stood again. Because you got to stand. And this time, Jehoshaphat said, hear me, Judah, and inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, and he will be established. Believe his prophets, and you will succeed. Can I talk right now? See, when I look at this, so many folk in churches are struggling today, and they need help. They got their prayer life right. They got the Bible reading right. But there's a few things they don't have right. They believe in the Lord their God. And then God is established, but he still isn't moving in their life. Somebody say, why isn't he moving in their life? Because there's one little element you have forgotten. Believe his prophets. Oh, y'all getting real quiet right now. See, nobody respects the prophet like they used to respect the prophet. Y'all ain't talking. But God says if you treat the least of them with harm, you treating me the same way. See, I put on pants just like you, but I don't know how to tell you this. I put them on in the face of God, not like you. Oh, y'all ain't got the clap. Or you get on your knees to pray, but I stand in his face to hear what he has to say. Oh, y'all ain't got a crap now. See, you got to believe in somebody. You got to believe in God. You got to believe in Jesus. You got to believe in the Holy Spirit. And you got to believe in the prophet. Oh, somebody say amen. Can I go a little deeper? I got to go, but I got to go a little deeper. Got to go a little deeper, see? Because, see, right now this is going to really make a whole lot of folk mad, and they're going to get real mad because they're going to exegete the Bible. And folks say it, they don't know what that means, but, you know. Anyway, watch this, everybody. Ephesians 4:11, here's what the Bible says. And God gave some apostles, pastors, teachers. Come on, somebody. Am I talking to somebody? Am I talking? Evangelist, am I talking, everybody? The five-fold ministry. Am I right? But I want to talk to everybody. Folks still believe there's an evangelist. Nobody has a problem. Y'all clap for the evangelist. Folks still believe there's a pastor. Somebody clap for the pastor. Am I talking to somebody? Somebody say amen. But then we get to the apostle. Folk got a problem with that one. But then Paul doesn't stop there. He goes on and says, but God appointed first in the church apostles. Now, how can you have a church if you don't have the one that he appointed first? Now I'm going to make y'all real mad. And then folk, they give more honor to the name that's not even in the Bible than the name that is in the Bible. And I ain't gonna call out that name because y'all know that'll make everybody mad because some folk attend the churches of that name. But that name ain't even in the Bible. But you love that. But the one that's in the Bible, you despise that. Watch the stand. What's the stand? The stand is when you believe in God. You believe in his prophets. Then you will succeed. Watch this. And when Jehoshaphat had taken counsel with the people, he appointed those who were to sing to the Lord and praise him in holy attire as they went before the army and say, give thanks to the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. Can I talk? Now, Lord, I understand. I stood on your truth. I stood on your word. Now I'm trying to stand on the power of praise. You told me I don't have to fight. You said the battle is yours, not mine. You told me where to go to meet them. But now you're unorthodoxed. You're telling me to do something that's not in the manual of warfare. But the weapons we fight with are not carnal, but they're mighty for the pulling down of strongholds. We fight not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and wickedness and evilness in high places. You can't fight the devil with your hands. You can't fight the devil with physical power. You've got to fight him in the spirit. Look at what the Bible says. And when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set an ambush against the men of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, Zaire, who could come against Judah, so that they were routed. For the men of Ammon and Moab rose against the inhabitants of Mount Seir, devoting them to destruction. And when they had made an end of the inhabitants of Zaire, they all helped to destroy one another. I got to go now. I was about to put this thing down, y'all. And the Lord said, if you put it down, Pleasant, you're going to miss the best part. I said, Lord, what's the best part? He said, it's right there, starting at verse 22. I said, Lord, you got to show it to me now. What's right there in 22? He said, you don't understand. But all of the multitudes of enemies who didn't even like themselves got together to come against Israel. The Lord said, tell the people, you don't realize it, but somebody in your job, somebody in your family, all of them coming together because they don't like you, and they're planning, and they're plotting, and they're looking at your weakness. They've already planned the day of your pink slip. Y'all don't understand. Any day I can walk on my job, I've already told my wife, and they're gonna hand me the pink slip, and they're gonna be surprised when I get that pink slip.
They're going to expect me to cry or to show a look of anxious in my body. But do y'all know I've already prepared what I'm going to do? My response is going to be, bless the Lord, all my soul and all that is within me. Why? Because his mercy endureth forever. Then I'm going to step back a little bit more. And I'm going to start moving my feet right there in the HR office. And then I'm going to say, that's okay. That's all right. I know this. My God shall supply all my need according to his riches in glory. Can I get an amen, somebody? That's what's called praise. Y'all ain't clapping now. Can I get somebody to praise him? You got to praise him in the middle of what looks like a defeat. You got to praise him in the middle of them attacking you. You got to praise them when all the odds are against you. On your worst day, that ought to be your most praising day. Can I get somebody to praise God? Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say thank you. Somebody say glory. Somebody say yeah. Somebody say I'm gonna praise him till my victory comes. I'm gonna praise him till the shackles fall off my feet. I'm gonna praise him. But can I talk real quick? I gotta get ready to go. But can I say one more thing? The reason you're listening to this message and the reason that you're here is I want you to know right now, you're on the battlefield right now. Your enemy is coming down, but you're going up. Somebody say yeah. Watch the scripture. It says they're coming down, but you're going up. That's what the scripture says. That's your position. Your position is that they're coming down and you're going up. They want to bring you down, but they're really elevating you up. Somebody say yeah. That's how you fight with spiritual weapons. Somebody say hallelujah in this place. Now I gotta go, but I want you to understand the reason you're here right now, because I want you to get ready to praise God. Some of y'all say, why? Because you missed the best part. When they started praising God, the enemy turned on themselves and they began to fight each other. First, the two strongest fought each other. Then they got rid of the other one. Somebody say amen. Y'all ain't talking to me. There are four people coming against you in your life right now. But if you start praising God in this building right now, they are plotting against you. But they're going to start fighting against themselves. Somebody say yeah. Right now they're at that table. And now they're beginning to argue about what they're going to do to you. Y'all ain't talking now. They just sent the email. But somebody responded that they don't like what the email sound like. That's supposed to bring you down. Y'all ain't clapping. I'm here to tell you that when the praises go up, the enemy comes down. Somebody say yeah. Can somebody praise him now? Can you get them fighting each other now? Can you get them destroying each other now? Somebody say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Come on, somebody. Give him a praise in this place. In the awesome. Y'all ain't praising him enough. You ain't praising him enough. I see your enemy falling right now. Instead of them stabbing you in the back, they stabbing each other in the back. They started off 20 minutes ago talking about you. Now they're talking about each other. Y'all didn't hear me. They were planning on letting you go tomorrow, but they gonna get fired tomorrow. Somebody say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Can I get somebody to praise him? Praise him for your victory. Praise him for your strength. And all you got to do is just stand. Stand in the word of God. Stand in the power of God. Stand in the peace of God. Stand on the word. Stand on the promise. He is a king. He is a champion. Somebody said he never lost a battle. Never lost a case in court. Never lost defeat in the courtroom. Somebody say yeah. Never lost a patient in the hospital. Say yeah. Can I walk it out? Did the preacher preach today? Did a word come today? Do you feel power right now? Somebody say yeah. Say yeah. Ain't he all right? His mercy endureth forever. If he did it for me, he'll do it for you. Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Can I walk it out? Can I walk it out? I think I'll walk it out. I think I'll walk it off. I'ma walk it on off. I'ma walk it 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 off. I think I'ma shout it off. I'ma step it off. I'ma step it off. I'ma dance and dance till I can't dance no more. The battle ain't mine. It's the Lord. Somebody say yeah. Say yeah. Fighting no more. I'm 60 years old. I ain't got time to fight. I'ma shout it out. I'ma praise it out. I'ma dance it out. Somebody say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. We'll be right back.
situation, some circumstances, some decisions, you got to put a little praise on it. Come on now, yeah. Some things you got to put a little praise on it. Come on now, yes. Hey, some things you just got to put a little praise on it to let God move. Hey, to let him move. Yes, the importance of praising. Come on now, sometimes you know that you got to just praise the Lord. Lift it up before him. Praise him in advance for what he's doing. Praise him for who he is and what he's already done. Oh, praise him for doing exceedingly abundantly above anything you can ask or imagine, anything you can do on your own. Only by the power of God. Hallelujah. Hey, you got to put some praise on it. Hey, we're just telling you the truth. I'm reminded when the Israelites were called out of Egypt. They had to make the mass exodus. And God said, you're going to leave at a moment's notice. Only pack the necessities. Hey, but some praisers made sure they packed their tambourines. Because they knew that you're going to have to put some praise on it. We coming out of this thing. We coming out of this thing. We coming out of slavery. We coming out of this thing. We coming out of this situation. We coming out of this thing. We coming out of this thing. But we're going to have to come forth with praising him, with song and dance and word and a voice to say, you are my God and I trust you. I believe you. Oh, it may look cloudy right now. The situation may look dark. I don't know, Lord. I don't know each step to take. But one thing I do know is I'm going to take one step each time. Just take one step after another, praising you all in advance. One step. Standing on the word of God, standing on the truth of his word, and standing on his praise. Hey, he didn't put it in the Bible for no reason. He put it in the Bible because it's powerful. Hey, hey, thank you, Lord. Changing situations right now because of your praise. Changing situations right now. Clearing minds, sound minds right now. Your children acting right, finding their purpose right now because of your praise. Come on now. Sickness in your body being healed right now. It can't stay there. Your body is full of praise. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Relationships, marriages being restored right now in the name of Jesus because of your praise. Getting stronger, going to the next level. Wisdom in your decisions right now in the name of Jesus. If you said you're going to walk away, keep walking because that's what God told you to do and praise him all the way. Come on now. In the name of Jesus. Elevation. Everywhere you walk, you carry praise with you. Come on now. Hey, hallelujah. The favor of God is all upon you because the praise of God is all upon you. You walk in the situations. On jobs, in the classroom, in the courtroom, in the hospital room, and the favor of God is all upon you because you've been praising him. Those crooked places have to get straight, straighten up and fly right in the name of Jesus. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Hey, thank you, Lord. Yes. Hey. Oh, Lord, yes, come on now, yes, come on now, praise him, he's so good, he's been so good, he's brought you out of things that they said you could never get out of, he done brought you out of so many things, hey, hallelujah, he done brought you through so many situations, he's not going to give up on you now, keep praising him, keep praising him, keep praising him. Keep praising him. Hey, he has come through time after time, after time, after time, after time, after time. He's not going to give up on you now. Praise him. Thank you, Jesus. Yahweh, Father God, we love you. It's in your will, it's in your hands. We're gonna do our part, and that's to praise you in advance. Hey, hey, hey. Yes, Lord. If I can't do anything else, I can open my mouth and lift up a praise to your name. When my body is tired, when I feel weak, I can open up my mouth and lift up a praise to your name. Yes, Lord, I'm going to praise you. Until my strength comes, I'm going to praise you. Until the situation changes, I'm going to praise you. Hey, hallelujah. If you never do another thing for me, Lord, I'm going to praise you, because you already done too much. Hey, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I hope you feel your breakthrough has come. You've been delivered. You've been set free. You got praise on your heart, praise in your mind, praise in your spirit. You walk in the favor of the Lord. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Doesn't matter how long it takes, he can change it in an instant. He can turn that situation around in an instant. He can change it just like that. He can change it just like that. Hey. Yes, hallelujah. Hey. He's just waiting on your praise, your continued praise. In the good times, in the challenging times, in the bad times, praise him. One thing that's got to stay the same is our praise, because he is a God that does not change, and you are his child. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Yes. Hallelujah. We serve a mighty God. Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. He's a good God. Yes. Our reflection question for the week is, praise is one of the most powerful spiritual weapons that you possess to defeat demonic attacks that you are experiencing in your life. Hallelujah. Yes. Things that we don't even know that are happening. The praise, your praise will silence your enemies. Yes. Silence that situation. Change it. Turn it around. We thank God for his power. Hey, hallelujah. We thank God for his goodness. If you're out there and you're listening to the word of God today and the Lord is speaking to your heart, he's telling you that he has ordained praise from you. It starts with that personal relationship with him, knowing Jesus as your Lord and your Savior. Without a doubt, knowing that when you close your eyes on this side, to be absent from the body will be present with the Lord. To know without a doubt that he is your Savior. You got to know that in order to praise him. You got to know what he did, what he saved you from. If the Lord is moving upon your heart today and you've not accepted that personal relationship with Christ, today is your day. This is your day. Let us all say this statement of faith together. This day, I confess with my mouth that Jesus is my Lord and Savior. I further believe in my heart that God raised him from the dead. And as a result, this salvation I have received is immutable. Yes, the immutability of God. Never changing. Some of us have some family members in our lives right now that don't know the Lord. They're not walking with him. They haven't accepted Christ as their Lord and Savior. Right now, Lord, we're praising you in advance for those that will come to the knowledge of you. Family members that will be saved, that will walk in your power, Lord. right now, we're praising you for that, Lord. We thank you for that. If you said that for the very first time today, you have accepted Christ's salvation. If you're there watching us via virtual, let us know. And our prayer pastors, prayer partners, and pastors will reach out to you and they'll pray with you if you're there online. If you're here in person, we'll also arrange to get to you that birth certificate of eternal salvation, indicating that this is the day that you stepped into the Lord's family. When you accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior, this is your day. And we'll give that birth certificate of eternal salvation, indicating that you've done that today. And if you're out there and you're listening and you don't have a relationship with the Lord that you feel is strong right now, you know you're saved, but you're not walking with him like you used to, come on and rededicate your life today. He called us to live an abundant life. Joy, peace, love, all of the fruit of the Spirit, power. If you want to rededicate your life today, come up after service and let us know. Let us know there on YouTube and on the virtual platforms as well. And then last but not least, if you don't have a church home, become a member of New Zion today to get a powerful word, to be empowered to go out and be a transformational person in your community, in this world. Become a member today. Salvation, rededication, becoming a member. Let us know and we will gladly step you through either of those. August 20th is Whole Tide Sunday. New Zionites, guests and visitors, is it the offering time? Yes, hallelujah. It's offering time. Hey, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And we celebrate when it's offering time because the Lord loveth a cheerful giver. So we celebrate, for we know that all that we have is only because of him. We follow that Malachi 3:8-10 scripture that says, bring ye the whole tithe into the storehouse that there may be meat in my house. And prove me now, herewith says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open up the windows of heaven. He's got some windows in heaven he wants to open up for you and pour you out a blessing that you shall not have room enough to receive. Step into that tithing relationship with him today and watch him prove that. Watch him prove it. We know here at New Zion that instead of saying, I can't afford to tithe, we always need to say, I can't afford not to. Don't forget that investment and savings challenge. Now we're going to watch a tithing video with a video representation of tithing.
Before they got married in 2007, Chris and Bethany Clopton had a serious talk about money.
When we talked about our family game plan, strategic plan, you know, we were in tune and equally yoked. We just knew we tithe together.
I knew he was financially stable and he would give and tithe, and we were kind of on the same page.
As the director of fundraising for Purdue University, Chris cultivated relationships with donors who gave to the athletics department. For the next 11 years, his job provided a good salary that allowed Bethany to homeschool their four children. The couple continued to stay on track and faithfully tithe.
It's a part of my DNA. For me, it's tithing because I'm blessed. Before any decisions are made, this is the 10 that is coming off the top.
It's something we always did and knew, you know, that there's benefits to tithing, and why would we want to step outside those benefits?
And then in the winter of 2018, Chris felt led to make a career change, a different direction.
But I wasn't actively looking. I was meeting with a donor one day in my office, and, you know, mid-sentence, he stops me and says, have you ever thought about doing something different?
That donor was a senior executive at an international IT company. With his education and sales experience, Chris was a perfect fit for a position in the organization.
So there was a lot of prayer. There was a lot of seeking counsel.
In the spring of 2019, they agreed Chris would accept the executive sales job in the cybersecurity field that came with a 45% salary increase over the salary from his previous job.
You talk about a leap of faith. I mean, I jumped off the cliff, new industry, new everything. It was a huge learning curve.
For 11 months, everything in the new company went well for Chris. In 2020, when the pandemic halted the workflow for many industries around the world, Chris's number one key retail account began to fall apart.
You know, this is one of our larger accounts. If they walk away, it would lose a lot of money for, you know, for our company.
Chris's division had to work from home.
I'm homeschooling while he's in the office working.
Conversation after conversation was getting nowhere, and I remember talking to my wife and just like, I have no idea what to do. And I remember she was saying, hey, let's just, you know, let's pray.
Within a few months, the breakthrough happened. Chris closed what he calls a transformational deal with his client. When the commission check came in, he immediately told Bethany the good news.
And I remember, you know, my wife in tears, like, oh, I can't wait to make a tithe. It was going to be our biggest tithe yet.
I laughed. I cried. I was so overwhelmed and blessed that God would take us from where we were and just bless us over the top.
Today, Chris is a cybersecurity solutions account executive. Bethany has opened up her own art and jewelry shop. They love spending time together as a family, and they continue to tithe with hearts filled with joy.
That tithing is a testament to what he's done and the blessing and the fullness of it coming forth.
You know, again, it's all about being a good steward. I am blessed. I am prosperous. It's 100% because of God.
Amen. Yes, it's 100% because of God. Yes, we know that here at New Zion, there are three ways to give: Tithely, PayPal, and Cash App. QR code there. And then also, if you're here in person, you can give through your white envelope for your tithes and your offerings. After you've given your tithes and offerings, and only if the Holy Spirit so moves you, only if the Holy Spirit so moves you, you may bless Apostle and the First Family by giving in the gold envelopes in person and by Tithely, PayPal, and Cash App also as well. We're now, the hosts are going to come forward and direct you to bring your offerings to the altar and place them in the basket. We're going to listen to announcements as you are now in the hands of the hosts.
Welcome to the service, ladies and gentlemen. Let us take a pause for the cause. Here are the happenings at the Z. Attention all guests, visitors, and friends. If you're visiting New Zion Christian Church for the first time today, either in person or virtually, please be sure to check in by scanning the QR code on your screen. And welcome to the Z. Attention New Zionites, guests, friends, and family. Join us tonight at 8:30 p.m. for the Sunday Night Call with June Collier as we continue our new series entitled Financial Fluency, Mastering Investment Vocabulary. We'll see you this evening at 8:30 p.m. Join us this Wednesday via Oxano University as we continue the People of the Promise, A Kingdom Divided. Each student is asked to complete Lesson 17, Part 2, in order to properly prepare for this week's lecture. This week's topic, Judah's Path into Exile, Part 2. And don't forget, your reflection question is due. Join us first and third Thursdays at 8:30 p.m. for the Entrepreneurs Roundtable with Brother June Collier. For more information, visit ertmeeting.com. That's ertmeeting.com. You must register in order to attend. Our next session is August 3rd at 8:30 p.m. Join Pastor Ray and friends this Thursday at 6 p.m. for Teen Bible Study as they meet to discuss relevant topics for the younger generation. Direct your teen and others to visit theZonline.org/teen Bible Study this Thursday at 6 p.m. Glory Ministry is still on summer break, but we will meet next week, August 6th, via the Zoom Room. We'll see you then. Attention, mighty men of valor. Attention, women of purpose. MMOV and WAP will be on summer break during the month.
Okay, we're going to go ahead and cut those announcements short. You can see the rest of those online, and we also will send them out to you as well. Let us go ahead and do our New Zion mantra. Apostle has been so compendious and so amazingly quick with the word of God, powerful word of God. Let's go ahead and keep. Wasn't that word powerful? Come on now, that's just what we needed. Yes, he's been coming with that word, so powerful. We're going to say our New Zion mantra. We'll say our prayer, and then we'll do our New Zion mantra. Of course, we are still excited about our July birthdays. I know that Minister James Lawrence's birthday is on the 31st. Miles Coney was on the 23rd, Jeremiah 21st, Elder Lawrence on the 20th, Becky's was on the 19th, along with Pastor Mike Mitchell, as well as many others. Sister Betty, Elder Betty's birthday was the 14th, Sonia Hickman, Jamila, Kalila, Damika, everybody celebrating birthdays. Exciting, we have an exciting anniversary. The Jeans are celebrating their 30th year anniversary on tomorrow. Yes, July 31st. They are actually on a cruise with the Gibbs and the Jeans. The Gibbs have been on their 100th cruise this year, and so we are excited about them and their cruising. But pray for their continue to pray for their safety. But they're having a great time. Brother Sean and Sister Emily, of course, July 17th for 20 years. Elders Lyndon and Elder Michelle, 25 years. Of course, remember that on July the 11th. And then John and Rhonda, 22 years on July the 7th. So we lift all of those up. Yes, we love strong marriages and that you guys are healthy for your birthdays and all those other great things. Lifting up Sister Sabrina, keep her lifted up for continued healing. Pastor Mike, Daddy Mike Mitchell, continue to lift him up for healing, as well as all others that we know God's healing power is upon, because we're going to praise that thing through. Come on now. We're going to praise it through. All right. And so we are excited about praise reports, how God is blessing, how he's continued to bless all of us and keep us all healthy and just doing amazing things. I want to actually lift up the kids as they're going to be going back to school soon. I know Courtney will be going off to college. Kyle will be starting his first year of college. Zion will be going back. Yes. Many of them will be going off to college. And then and Haley's going off to her first year of college. Oh, my gosh. And then, of course, all of the students that are going back to school. Let this be an amazing year for them. I love it. Hallelujah. All right. So let's pray, and then we'll do our new Zion mantra. Father God, Daddy Yahweh, we just love you so much. We come before you in the name of your son, Jesus, and by the power of your sweet Holy Spirit, Lord, giving you all praise, all honor and glory. Lord, you are a good God to us, Lord. And Lord, thank you so much that when we stand on your word, when we stand on your truth, when we stand on your praise, Lord, you transform situations, Lord. Lord, you go out and you heal our bodies. You make crooked places straight, Lord. You change situations. You change mindsets. You cause children to walk right, Lord. You cause relationships to come together, Lord. You just bless us. You elevate us on our jobs, Lord. Elevate us in our schools, Lord. You do exceedingly abundantly above anything that we can ask or imagine. And just because we praise you and we trust you. So, Lord, right now we continue to praise you in our spirit, trusting you with all our heart. Lord, continue to heal bodies, Lord. Continue to strengthen bodies, Lord. Strengthen minds, Lord. Continue to give us new opportunities, Lord. But, Lord, continue to remind us that you are our God. And there's no situation too hard, nothing that we go through that you aren't with us. And that you are working it out for our good, even when we don't know it. Lord, we love you so much, and we praise you so much. Continue to bless us and keep us, and we will give you the honor, the glory, and the praise. In Christ's name, the people of New Zion said amen. Amen, amen, amen. Let's say our New Zion, yes, praise God, praise him. Yes. Let's say our New Zion mantra together loud and strong. I love the Lord. I love my church. I lead people to the Lord. I lead people to my church. I'm proud of my apostle. I'm proud of my pastors. I'm proud of my church. I tell people about my church. I work in my church. I'm a part of something big in my church. I'm a part of something here that is bigger than me. I am a part of history and what this church will become. I am a winner. I am a conqueror. I am an overcomer. I am a proud, anointed, and appointed member of New Zion. We are special. We are called. We are a kingdom. We are a nation. We are a priesthood. I am proud to be a part of this great church. Give God a hand clap of praise. Amen, amen, amen. We're going to move into our communion service very quickly. And you all have a wonderful week praising the Lord all the way.